clinical picture of femoral hernia. First of all, the femoral hernia lies in a characteristic site, which is below the inguinal ligament. This is the inguinal ligament, and the swelling is below the inguinal ligament. And the swelling is below and lateral to the pubic tubercle. Here is the position of the pubic tubercle, and the femoral hernia is below and lateral to the pubic tubercle. This is the characteristic site for the femoral hernia, below the inguinal ligament, below and lateral to the pubic tubercle. The direction of reduction and descent is characteristic and diagnostic. How? The femoral hernia, when you ask the patient to cough, the hernia descends downward in the femoral ring and femoral canal, then forward through the saphenous opening, then upwards and laterally. The direction of reduction is downward, backward, and upward. Special tests are diagnostic. If you close the saphenous opening, which is below and lateral to the pubic tubercle, 4 centimeters, below and lateral to the pubic tubercle, compress the saphenous opening and ask the patient to cough, femoral hernia does not appear as a swelling. Internal ring test is diagnostic. If you close the internal inguinal ring, and ask the patient to cough, the internal inguinal ring is here. If you close the internal inguinal ring and ask the patient to cough, the swelling of femoral hernia will appear below and lateral to the pubic tubercle and below the inguinal ligament. Here is the internal inguinal ring. If you close the internal inguinal ring and ask the patient to cough, the femoral hernia pass below and lateral to the inguinal ligament and the pubic tubercle. Zeeman test is diagnostic. If you put 3 fingers, one finger on the internal ring, one finger medial to the internal ring, that's to say on the Hasselbach's triangle, and one finger on the saphenous opening, and if you ask the patient to cough, if impulse on cough in the internal ring, it is oblique inguinal hernia. If impulse on cough in Hasselbach's triangle, it is direct inguinal hernia. If impulse on cuff on the saphenous opening, it is a femoral hernia. What is the differential diagnosis of femoral hernia? First of all, the most important is differential diagnosis between inguinal hernia and the femoral hernia. First of all, relation to the inguinal ligament. The inguinal hernia is above the inguinal ligament, while the femoral hernia is below the inguinal ligament. Relation to pubic tubercle. Inguinal hernia is above and medial to the pubic tubercle, while femoral hernia is below and lateral to the pubic tubercle. Sure, direction of reduction, direction of descent, and the special tests are characteristic for the type of hernia and differentiate inguinal hernia from femoral hernia. Also, differential diagnosis include other swellings in the femoral triangle because femoral hernia is a swelling in the femoral triangle. If reducible femoral hernia, what are the differential diagnosis of femoral hernia in this case? First of all, reducible inguinal and reducible obturator hernia, saphena varix, psoas called abscess, femoral aneurysm. To remember the differential diagnosis in any anatomical site, remember the anatomy of the area. What is the differential diagnosis of reducible femoral hernia? Reducible inguinal hernia, and very close in the medial aspect of the thigh, there is reducible obturator hernia. There is a femoral vein in the femoral triangle, therefore remember saphena varix, which is a type of varicose vein in the femoral triangle. Remember that the femoral triangle containing the femoral artery and the femoral aneurysm may arise in this area. There is iliopsoas muscle, and the iliopsoas muscle in relation to it, there may be psoas called abscess. Therefore, to remember the differential diagnosis, always remember the anatomy. The first differential diagnosis for reducible hernia is other reducible hernias, reducible inguinal and obturator. Plus, one structure arises from the vein like saphena varix. One structure arises from the artery aneurysm. One structure may arise from the iliopsoas, which is psoas called abscess. If the hernia is irreducible, it may be irreducible inguinal or irreducible obturator hernia, or enlarged inguinal lymph nodes. Lymph node enlargement is a commonest swelling in the femoral triangle. Ectopic femoral testis. There may be ectopic testis in the femoral triangle, or liboma, or sarcoma. This is a differential diagnosis of femoral hernia. What is the treatment of femoral hernia? Treatment of femoral hernia is only surgical, and the truss is contraindicated. Why? Because it is the most liable hernia for complication. Therefore, the operation should be done as soon as possible. The most recommended and the most liable technique nowadays is laparoscopic hernioplasty using a synthetic mesh. After reduction of the hernia, the femoral ring is closed by a synthetic polypropylene mesh as usual. This is the most popular nowadays, if available. If not available, open surgery can be considered. Open surgery is done by one of the following approaches. Let us take the approaches historically. The oldest approach which was used is low approach, which is incision below and parallel to the inguinal ligament, over the swelling. This low approach exposes the femoral hernia in the thigh, like that. Expose the femoral hernia here, or better picture, expose the femoral hernia here in the femoral triangle. If a low approach is done, it has many disadvantages. First of all, the first rule in herniotomy is excision of the hernial sac at the proper neck. In low approach, it is nearly impossible to divide the hernial sac at the proper neck, leaving a small part of the sac, leading to recurrence. Another important thing, if there is associated inguinal hernia, the low approach cannot be used to treat associated inguinal hernia. It is very common to do the operation for femoral hernia during strangulation. If there is a strangulated content, you can do resection anastomosis in the side in the femoral triangle. And if there are strangulation, important step in strangulation is to relieve the constricting agent, which is usually the lacunar ligament. If you try to divide the lacunar ligament from here, from below, from the side, from the femoral triangle, there is great liability to injury the abnormal obturator artery. What is the abnormal obturator artery? If this is the lacunar ligament, and you've been here, low, below the lacunar ligament in the side. The lacunar ligament has two surfaces. Surface below toward you, and a surface here toward me in the abdomen. And abnormal obturator artery passing here from the abdominal side of lacunar ligament. If you open low approach and you try to divide the lacunar ligament, you will divide the abnormal obturator artery with massive bleeding. What is the abnormal obturator artery? Normally, there are two famous arteries in this region. Sure, this is the abdominal side of the anterior abdominal wall. That's to say, this is a posterior view to the anterior abdominal wall. And here, there is the external iliac artery giving the inferior epigastric artery. The inferior epigastric artery gives the abiobic branch. To anastomose with abiobic branch of this large artery, which is called obturator artery. This anastomosis is a small anastomosis and lies behind the lacunar ligament, in the abdominal side of the lacunar ligament. In about 30% of people, the obturator artery may be absent. And the pubic branch of the obturator will be absent. And the obturator artery is replaced by a large pubic branch of inferior epigastric. The large pubic branch of inferior epigastric is called now the abnormal obturator artery, which will pass in the obturator canal to the medial aspect of the side. And the abnormal obturator artery will pass here at the lateral border of lacunar ligament. And if you try to divide the lacunar ligament, hemorrhage will occur due to injury of the abnormal obturator artery. Therefore, low approach is not done nowadays due to his disadvantage. Nowadays, high approach should be done. High inguinal approach means incision like inguinal hernia. Inguinal incision above and parallel to the medial two-thirds of the inguinal ligament. We open the skin, open the anterior wall of the inguinal canal, which is external abdominal oblique. You will find the content of the canal, which is the spermatic cord. Retract the spermatic cord. And open the posterior wall of the inguinal canal, which is fascia transversalis. You will see this picture. This is the open the skin, superficial fascia, subcutaneous fat, We open the external abdominal oblique, two flaps, upper flap and lower flap. The spermatic cord is retracted. We open the fascia transversalis above. There is conjoint tendon, and below there is the femoral ring. After reduction of the femoral ring and the proper excision of the sac at the proper neck, obliterate the defect, obliterate the femoral ring. How? We can obliterate simply the femoral ring by taking sutures between the inguinal ligament. This is the main part of the inguinal ligament. And this ligament, which is called pectineal ligament. This is the most simple. You can obliterate the femoral ring and strengthening of the posterior wall of the inguinal canal by suturing the conjoint tendon to the pectineal ligament. Suturing conjoint tendon to the pectineal ligament will support the posterior of the inguinal canal and will obliterate the femoral ring. This repair can be considered as a treatment for femoral hernia and inguinal hernia, and called McVeigh repair, which is suturing the inguinal, the pectineal ligament to the conjoint tendon. Here we will separate the conjoint tendon. Will separate. This is the femoral ring. The conjoint tendon comes here, separating the peritoneum and the abdominal structures from the femoral ring in front of the conjoint tendon. Therefore, the conjoint tendon here is a barrier between the peritoneum and abdominal structure in one side and the femoral ring from the other side. We can also obliterate the femoral ring by suturing the conjoint tendon to the pectineal ligament to the inguinal ligament. Therefore, this is called the high inguinal approach. But if there is a strangulated femoral hernia, so through this approach, you can deal with the strangulated content and you can do resection anastomosis for the gangrenous intestine? No. Therefore, during strangulation and without opening of the inguinal canal to avoid weakening of the inguinal canal in the previous approach, because in the previous approach you will open the inguinal canal and opening the fascia transversalis, this produce weakening of the inguinal canal. Therefore, this incision is called high McEvedy incision. High McEvedy incision is originally a vertical incision. A vertical incision above the level of the inguinal ligament, along the lateral border of the lower part of the rectus sheath. This is the rectus sheath. We open here. Incision at the lower part of the lateral border of the rectus abdominis and rectus sheath. To open the abdomen and open the skin and all the structures to enter the abdomen above the inguinal ligament. You will see in this case, this picture, you will see the hernial sac and the proper neck, and you do everything. This incision may be extended downward in the skin only along the inguinal crease to the upper part of the thigh to expose the fundus of the hernial sac if the hernia is irreducible or strangulated. We will extend the skin incision in the skin only to the upper part of the thigh to expose the fundus, open the fundus, evacuate the dirty fluid from the fundus, dissect the content, reduce the content, etc. Therefore, the original McAvity approach is vertical incision above the level of the inguinal canal, at the level of the lower part of the lateral border of the rectal sheath. If the hernia is irreducible or strangulated, you can extend the skin incision only to the upper part of the thigh to expose the fundus. And we should finally mention that the main treatment of femoral hernia nowadays is laparoscopic hernioplasty by synthetic mesh. This is the recommended technique nowadays. If not available, open surgery should be done, either by high inguinal approach or high McAvity approach. And the low approach is nowadays considered hysterical and not performed nowadays. Thank you for good listening about this video.